of one of the generations today were doing a video with a face cam because someone suggested that I should use a face cam, and I'm like, why not do it? So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy it with a face cam. I'm only gonna do this for the post commentary stuff because I need to figure out how to properly do it during the gameplay. I tried a little bit before, but that didn't really work out too well, so I'm just gonna do it during the post commentary for now. So yeah, this time is the warrior tank video versus tank videos. And yeah, I changed Thanos one bit compared to the last video, which is the Storm build that I picked, because this one is a lot better for single target compared to the Shockwave, which is for multi-target. But I just took that out of plain habit, essentially. So Impending Victory, Ultimatum, Crackling Thunder, Indomitable, Booming Force, Heavy Repercussions, and then in the on the Thanos adaptation, Relentless Assault, Sword and Board, Rage Machine, Shield Bash, and Thunderstruck. And these are the ones that I like to use personally. It's like always a little room for personal flavor, and maybe there's something better that I didn't figure out. So this is going to be against tanks. I'm going to return like after the video to talk about where do I think the tanks are in terms of like a cheer list, if you want to have one of those things, because you know, people are interested in that, like what tank is the most viable, which tank is the least viable, that kind of stuff. So yeah, let's get into the gameplay and see what happens to the Prot Warrior versus the tanks I could find, because the Brewmaster Monk and the Guardian Druid are almost impossible to find. So let's get into the gameplay. So I'm gonna add some minor commentary into this part. So I was fully expecting to get completely destroyed here. Obviously it's not that smart to fight on the Consecration, but I was just seeing like how much damage does the Paladin do at optimal conditions. And as you can see, just the healing versus my no healing whatsoever. It's like not even a contest actually, who's winning or who's losing. It's like they even toy around with me, because they could have killed me already. So yeah, without effort I get beaten here. So here's the Vengeance Demon Hunter. This one I wasn't too sure about. I actually was impressed with the fact that I managed to survive fairly long against both the Vengeance Demon Hunter and the Blood DK actually, which you'll see after this one. And yeah, I actually forget to spend my rage on Ignore Pain. And here I finally realize, oh wait, I'm at full. So because that's essentially what you use to survive is the Ignore Pain, which is my tree ability. That's actually the thing you really need to like keep up as much as you can. And you can increase your damage with Shield Slam with Focus Rage, which is on my E button. But you need like then you sacrifice survivability because you can't use Ignore Pain. So I actually managed to get the Venge Demon fairly low. Here you can see that I'm losing. It's like if Protection Warrior had like 10% more self-healing in any form, I would have actually been able to beat this guy. So yeah, I was actually fairly impressed with Protection Warrior there. But still, it's like I felt like this guy wasn't really going full out on me there. So here we go against the Blood Dead Knight. I put Vengeance Demon Hunter and Blood Dead Knight at the same spot. I'd say Blood Dead Knight might edge out a little bit, but I'd say they're fairly equal at the moment because I lost with my Blood Dead Knight against the Vengeance Demon Hunter. But I think they're fairly equal. It's like it's one, it can fall both ways. That's why I put them at the same spot. But yeah, the self healing is just crazy. So that previous blood, that Vengeance Demon Hunter was actually not playing that well because they weren't self-healing as much as I did on my Vengeance Demon Hunter. So they should have beaten me easier. So yeah, it's like I felt against this fight, in this fight I just felt like playing an uphill battle because you could just see their self-healing and the amount of damage that linked to the self-healing is just sick. I was really happy though that I could play against the Blood Dead Knight for comparison. So yeah, like I'm actually impressed with how long I managed to hold out. It's like you can hold out for a very long time, but you will never win. That's the problem. So yeah, this is going to be the end of the gameplay soon. And I'm gonna go into the last post commentary. And here we lose. So as you could see in these videos, that Protection Warrior is obviously lower in the tier list than Protection Paladin, Blood DK, and Vengeance Demon Hunter. I actually have to say that I personally held it a little bit longer against those tanks than people who played against me on those tanks did. For example, when I played Blood that night, I had no problem killing Protection Warrior, same with Vengeance Demon Hunter, and on Protection Paladin, I had no Protection Warrior had no chance against my Protection Paladin. So that brings me to like the tier list. And I've said that Protection Paladin is number one. And then at number two, it's like a shared number two between Blood Dead Knight and Vengeance Demon Hunter. And then at number three, I'd say Guardian Druid. Well, four actually. So at number four, like the Guardian Druid. And then at five, I'd say Protection Warrior. It's like I've played against the Brewmaster Monk in a non-recorded video where it's like just a random brawl that just happened and I was too slow recording it. So it was like half a fight. So I didn't bother putting that in. So, and I beat the Brewmaster Monk on Warriors. I'd say Warriors then fifth, and then Brewmaster's probably the lowest. And the reason why I put Guardian Druid on fourth is because when I played against my Blood that night, I think I had a huge problem killing it because of the super, like the amount of self-healing that they did. So that's my tier list personally. So Protection Paladin first, Blood DK, Vengeance Demon Hunter, shared second. So, and then number four, Guardian Druid, number five, Protection Paladin, Protection Warrior, and then number six, the Brewmaster Monk. So, and as you can see in this video, I lost every duel. It's like Protection Warrior just can't handle the might of the tanks that I played against. It's like they just heal self heal too efficiently. It's like if Protection Warrior could self heal better, they would handle those tanks better. But since you don't, and those tanks actually self heal fairly easily themselves, because you only have like impending victories, the only self heal that you have. So good luck trying to fight against like a Blood Dead Knight that heals all the time, a Protection Paladin that can heal him or herself all the time, and then get held back from the Judgment of Light or whatever. And then like the Vengeance Demon Hunter who gets like held back from the Soul Fragments. And then you have the Guardian Druid who can just shapeshift and then heal themselves up again, as you can see in the Blood Dead Knight video. It's like the Brewmaster Monk you can handle because that only really heals with casting heals, and you can interrupt that, so that's why you can beat that. So yeah, sadly, Protection Warrior is kind of low on the tier list for those who are hoping to play Protection Warrior. It's like you're better off playing one of the other tanks unless you just don't care. It's like simple as that. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I enjoyed making it, and I hope you enjoyed the facecam. So I'll see you guys the next time.